Oh my goodness, what a difference a couple of days make.
Professor Noel Fitzpatrick.
All right, Mrs. Cuddle Monster incoming.
Is the super vet.
We have issues.
I knew I should have got chihuahuas.
At his unique vet practice, he merges mechanics and biology.
Past the point of no return now.
Don't be pulling apart my repair, missus.
To heal the nation's pets.
Sorry about coronavirus.
Oh, because you're responsible?
I'm responsible for almost everything else.
Even in the darkest days.
I'm so sorry this is happening to you.
Noel imagines the impossible.
Oh, my little baby girl's leg.
Let's go. Sometimes you have to bend the rules of mechanics to fit the biology.
And offers hope.
We've definitely made the right decision.
Good boy.
We've got my boy back.
For families and their friends.
Look at you, bionic doggo.
I'd love to work here, but I think it'd be such a hard job.
You just want to take them all home.
I would.
It's late afternoon at Fitzpatrick Referrals.
I read that as Fitzpatrick Ferrals. I was thinking, what, they got a whole part for feral dogs.
Sick and injured animals are waiting to check in to this one-of-a-kind animal hospital.
I'm Lauren, I'll be your anaesthesia nurse today.
And whilst a visit to the vets may not be everyone's idea of a fun day out...
Oh, look, he don't want to go in.
For nine-month-old cockapoo Betsy...
Yes?
It's become part of everyday life.
What's going on?
This is probably our 10th time down here or something like that. We've been coming since Betsy, our dog, was unfortunately hit by a van.
Yes! Yes!
You'd think that she'd be scared of the vets now after everything, but nope, she's amazing.
Yeah, she's full of energy.
I think everyone here loves her.
Everyone loves Betsy.
Betsy, wait.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Silly poo.
Betsy was just 4 months old when she was hit by a van.
I was taking her out for a walk. I was trying to put her back on the lead, and Betsy spotted it must have been a bird or something. And she just ran out straight across the road, and a big van went right over the top of her. She had fractures all the way down her spine, and she'd also torn nerves in her armpit, which meant that she lost feeling in her front right paw. You could go.
I can't imagine the pain she must have been in. She was wagging her tail after.
No!
She's unbelievable.
Betsy was so ill. There was multiple times that we thought that we had to let her go. And she was always the most bouncy, happy puppy that you will ever, ever see.
Unable to feel her front paw, Betsy drags and tears her skin.
Yeah!
There's no treatment for the nerve damage, so Sophie and Dan are considering amputation but want to know if Betsy could have a custom-made prosthesis called a Perfitz.
We're hoping this sort of bionic foot will allow her to move around much more naturally.
She's got a long life ahead of her. And if we can give her the opportunity to live that on four legs instead of three, I think that's the best thing to try for.
The couple are also expecting a baby in 5 weeks' time.
We've had a big course in adulting this year, I think it's fair to say.
Yeah.
Until now, the cheerful cockapoo has been under the care of Fitzpatrick's neurology team.
Hi, guys.
But as the only vet in the world performing Perfitz surgery, today Betsy will be meeting Noel.
Hello, 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 hello. You're about to pop any minute.
Almost.
Technically yeah. In 5 weeks.
All right, well, listen, if it happens in here, you're in good hands. I'm all over it. What an adorable doggy. Come on, missus. Here we go. Now, so you know that what Joanna's been investigating is whether the radial nerve is working and whether the ulnar nerve is working. And what I was particularly interested to see when we were outside in the yard earlier, she can retract the limb. Now, that's critical to function.
Yeah.
Because if she couldn't pull that leg forward and pull it backwards, from there up...
It would be an easy decision, wouldn't it, really?
Yes. Then we would be recommending a full limb amputation.
Yeah.
And this far out from the injury, if she has bicep function and if she has tricep function, I can see why it's a difficult decision for you to chop her leg off.
Yeah.
So then we come to the ethical dilemma.
Yeah.
With a dog this size, 9 out of 10 people would choose to chop the leg off because this is a very light dog and can run around happily on 3 legs. Mm. So you need to understand from the get-go, of course I can do this surgery, but is it ethically right to do it?
Yeah.
So my job today is to simply tell you the pros and cons.
Yeah.
And send you away to have a think.
Yeah.
The implant comprises 2 metal plates and 1 or 2 pegs that goes up into the bone.
Yeah.
The challenge is what the bit that comes through the skin.
Yeah.
And the reason that's a challenge is infection.
Yeah.
If you get a firm seal around the spigot by 21 days, you're good to go. We would generally say to people that if it's not working out by 1 month post-op, to take the leg off. Right, Joe's gonna go and change the dressing and we'll have a look at it now. I'll have a look at the wounds, okay?
Yeah.
So you have the facts now anyways.
Yeah.
Betsy's treatment will have to be reviewed by an independent ethics panel before it's given the go-ahead.
Every surgical procedure should be subject to appropriate ethics. And there's no blanket answer. Every patient is an individual.
Nearly finished, okay?
As a result, we have an ethics review panel to get a consensus of opinion if the family do choose a more advanced surgical option.
Even if they get the green light, there's a lot for Sophie and Dan to consider.
Well, objectively, I think based on that discussion, the... I'm trying to figure out, say, the...
On a probability-weighted basis.
And then there's the overlap of it with Davy Adams.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hi.
No, Betsy.
She's my best friend. I love you millions and millions and millions.
If she has the perfect, she'll be here for a lot, won't she?
Oh my God, I'll have a meltdown. I'm never. I'm not going to work.
Yes.
It's not straightforward. Lots of pros and cons to weigh up, and Noel's explained all those to us, so we've got some thinking to do.
Yeah. What do you think, Betsy? Birds. Yes.
Hello, Bobby.
I think everyone loves puppies. It's impossible not to love them.
Oh my goodness! Oh, so cute!
When I see a puppy, I just need to cuddle him and kiss him.
She's just amazing, right?
Everyone drops what they're doing to just cuddle the puppies.
You see this little ball of fluff, and it's like your ovaries just start to flutter.
Hi!
They are so vulnerable and they need our care even more than an adult dog.
Oh my God, he is so cute.
I think you need to get another puppy.
Very cute.
There's another puppy stealing hearts at Fitzpatrick's.
I don't think she knows what to think of today at the minute.
But unlike Betsy, who's a regular at the practice...
Angel, let's say hello.
It's nine-month-old puppy Angel's first visit.
She's cross.
No, she's
four. She's 9 months old, but she's tiny. Angel was the smallest of the litter. So the other dogs, I would say, are sort of up here, so she can actually walk under them.
Although Dog de Bordeaux Angel is half the size she should be, it's not her pint-sized proportions that has brought her to Fitzpatrick's.
So Angel got a problem with her two front legs. We have taken her to the vets and they said they hadn't come across it before. We were told that surgery may be successful, but we were also told that it might not help at all. So we came down for a second opinion just to see what Noel's thoughts were.
Kirsty and her family have always loved Dog de Bordeaux's. It started with their first dog, Bella.
I had Bella from when she was 9 months old, and my partner wanted to breed Bella. So we did, and then we had six beautiful Dog de Bordeaux puppies.
They were very, very noisy. I named Angel because she was really good. Angel was definitely the cutest puppy.
Angel stood out right from the beginning.
Because she was a bit of the runt of the litter, she wasn't getting fed as much. I had to step up and start bottle feeding her myself. In your arms, like a baby actually, yeah. So I just naturally had that bond with her from day one.
I think safe to say she likes that. Angel!
As the puppies grew, it became obvious that Angel wasn't just smaller. Sadly, like many short-nosed breeds, she had genetic problems.
When we go out for a walk, her brothers and sisters run, and Angel just waddles.
We always thought, oh, she's small, she's just compensating, maybe she's just not walking as right. But we started to notice with her front legs that they were sort of not growing as we think that they should have, sort of more as a bode effect. I'm really concerned about Angel. I just want to make sure that she gets the best treatment that she can get the best possible outcome.
I want Angel to get better so she can be happy and healthy and run around.
Hello, hello. Hiya. Hello, lovely people. Come on in here. Hello, mate. You're a beauty, aren't you? Oh, look at those lovely eyes. Yes. So I read the imaging report from the last place. Why did you want a second opinion in the first place?
They suggested sort of surgery to cut the top and the bottom bones.
Yes.
To have two external frames on each leg, but they weren't sure if it was going to be successful.
So let's begin at the beginning. There's three bones, humerus, radius, ulna. Sometimes there's an asynchronous growth between the radius and the ulna. In other words, the two bones don't grow at the same rate, the origin of which is genetic. And as a result, this acts like a bow string and this acts like a bow. Growth deformity occurs because of premature closure of the growth plate in the ulna. So that's keeping growing and that one isn't. Mm-hmm. You with me?
Yeah.
It subluxates the radial head. It pushes it out of the joint because it's in a finite space and it wants to keep growing, pushing it that way. So the question is she actually going to get worse? So it looks to me like on this CT scan that growth plate in the radius is still wide open, which means the leg's going to bend more. So my opinion is we should take a chunk out of the ulna here and allow the radius the breathing space it needs to complete its growth. I do not think that we should go down the route of a major and expensive surgery because I think that she'll probably cope without it.
Yeah, that's great. That's, yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
Do you want me to proceed?
Yeah.
Right, Mrs. You're going to come and meet all the girls and they'll all fall in love with you.
Oh, I didn't expect that.
Oh, you didn't?
No.
You happy enough to leave her?
Yeah.
Yeah, time is of the essence, I think.
Oh, bye, Angel. Love you so much.
All right, missus. Good girl. All right, cuddle monster incoming.
Sometimes the patients presented to me warrant complex surgical intervention, but simple solutions should always be considered. And for me, it is what is in the best interests of this individual patient. For Angel, an age-old technique may provide a very satisfactory solution.
I feel much more positive than I did this morning, that it's, you know, a simpler surgery.
Hello, lovely girl, how are you?
I just feel a bit sad because I've just had to say goodbye to her and wasn't really expecting that today, but I know she's in the best hands, so she'll be just fine.
Very good girl.
You're ridiculously cute. You're nice too. Oh, okay. I'm gonna be in the middle. Right, that's fine. That's all right. Stay, but don't get too excited. I mean. Good girl. Right, okay.
Cockapoo Betsy wasn't due back at Fitzpatrick's for another week.
Oh man, that's really horrendous.
But this afternoon, the 9-month-old puppy has been rushed in with a badly infected foot.
Just can't unsee that gruesome, rotting core.
Yeah, it was bad.
We've got an acutely critical situation, and I'm gonna need to have a very serious chat with Mum and Dad. All right, sweetie pie.
We've been to the local animal hospital today and they described it as her toes are actually falling off. The next level of concern, I think, is that the operation that we thought she was going to have is not going to be possible now because of the level of infection in her leg. So we might be... I feel like we've come here to have a conversation with Noel about a full amputation today, which is not what we were hoping for, but we had in mind as an outcome.
Betsy is still waiting for a decision from the ethics review about her perfits, but this infection may change everything.
I just feel like, I don't know, like guilty or something.
Guilty?
Well, yeah, because like we'd been the ones doing the bandages and stuff.
Hi, guys. I'm just going to chat to you where you are, if that's okay.
Yeah.
Got to maintain social distancing, so we're all set.
It's bad.
Yeah. Did the wound just get worse and worse?
On Wednesday night, it looked fine. And then it started smelling really badly, and we realised it was the dressing, and we took it off this morning, and it was just like, holy shit.
It's the worst thing I've ever smelled. I just don't know. I don't understand what happened in the course of a week.
I think that you've got a combination of abnormal sensation, sweating and impairment of blood supply, and necrosis has ensued.
Is it normal for it to progress that quickly?
It's not. Nothing about this is normal.
No.
This does change the ball game in terms of what we do next, because I have to take the foot off.
Yeah.
We truly can't know.
Yeah.
If bacteria from that lesion gives rise to bacteria elsewhere, which can affect a stump.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So the infection could come back. So it could be quiescent there that we don't know about. And right now, we only have two options. So option one is to do a partial amputation above that site and see how that heals, and then consider a limb amputation prosthesis into that stump at a later date.
Right.
And option two is to take the full limb off. So, you don't need to make a decision right now. We will take care of her here. She needs to stay here now. Last thing I want to stress for you, I don't want that on my conscience, and I don't want it on your conscience. I don't get stressed.
It's...
Leave the stress of your other baby to me.
Okay.
We need to decide whether we do a full amputation now or if we have a partial amputation, and then in a month's time try and do the implant operation. but if there's any sign of infection, you can't go on and put an implant into her bone. I mean, that's just too risky. So we'll see. I'm sure it'll work out in the end. That's our attitude to everything in life, so be fine.
There's too many lunches. Can people just not need lunch? Then life would be a lot easier.
Angel, darling.
Sleepy sleeps.
Angel, the Bijou dog de Bordeaux, is being prepped for surgery.
God. That hit the spot, didn't it, Angel?
The puppy's radius bones have grown more than her ulna bones, bending her front legs out of shape.
Right, let's go.
Noel is going to attempt to address the deformity and give her a better quality of life.
This is the joint surface here. This is the growth plate here. I'm putting a screw below the growth plate and above the growth plate, and I'm going to bridge it on the inside here.
To prevent Angel's still growing bones from distorting any further, Noel puts wire, in a figure of eight, between the screws to act as a bridge and halt the growth on that side.
This bridge will mean that the growth plate's going to stop growing as long as the bridge is in there. So this side won't grow, that side will grow a bit more, and it'll push the paw, hopefully, a bit more towards here. 2 metric ethylene, please. Right, we're going to do the second part of the procedure now, which is to chop out a segment of the ulna on both sides.
Removing a section of the ulna will relieve the bowstring effect and stop the leg bending any further.
Just going to pack it with collagen now. That stops the bleeding.
Noel then performs the same surgery on Angel's left forearm.
If the bridge I've put in there across the growth plate is causing too much ceasing of growth, then the foot could turn the opposite way. I may need to take this bridge out at a later date, depending on how things go. Hopefully this will get a good result for Angel. We could be doing a lot of other things this evening, but in the immortal words of Robbie Williams,
I'm loving angels instead.
All right, drop her slowly, move her back. There we go now, Angel, well done. That's much better, isn't it? Good girl.
It will be several weeks before Angel's legs stop growing. Only then will Noel know if the life-changing surgery has been a success.
Come on, Angel. Angel.
I'm loving angels instead.
Thank you.
In Theatre 2, Cockapoo Betsy's infected foot is about to be removed.
Towel clip.
After consulting with Noel and much deliberation, Sophie and Dan decided against amputating the whole leg.
Jack the table up, please.
In the hope that if they get the green light from the ethics review, they may be able to proceed with the perfits if the infection clears up.
I'm placing a tourniquet around the leg, and that stops it bleeding while I chop the foot off. It takes about 60 seconds. Okay, so now we've got a stump and we've removed the infected foot.
Betsy will have a course of antibiotics.
Well done, Betsy. Good girl.
And there's a chance that in a few weeks' time, she may finally get her bionic foot.
Oh, babe.
Mwah.
carefree cockapoo Betsy is back at Fitzpatrick's.
You want this?
But this time, she's not alone.
Good boy, Hugo. He's smiling.
The happy-go-lucky pup has been as accepting of new baby brother Hugo as she is of everything else in her life.
We were surprised that she's not that bothered, but she seems to recognise that this is a small person, not an animal. Don't you?
Not a cat.
Not a cat. Wait until he starts trying to ride her around the place or feeding her all her treats out of the cupboard. You're going to be in cahoots, aren't you? Yes.
Partners in crime.
Since Betsy's gangrenous paw was removed, there's been no sign of infection. And after being given the go-ahead from the ethics review...
Right, little scamp.
Sophie and Dan have decided to proceed with the perfect surgery.
Oh, look at that waggy tail.
Always wagging.
Betsy may be facing another operation.
Yay, Betsy! Yay!
But she's delighted to see her Fitzpatrick's family.
Betsy is happiness in a little fluffy black ball.
She is always just so happy to see everyone.
Yeah, look at me. Look at me.
She basically grew up with us, and I think she feels like a part of this family.
Betsy Boop. Betsy Boop, Betsy Boop, Betsy Boop.
I think that she knows that we saved her life.
I miss you, Betsy.
She's very grateful.
She really deserves to have the best that life can give her. Life and us can give her.
You won't have a new foot.
But you want to make.
You're going to have a new foot. Yes. Yes.
She's just the best dog.
Well, we're going to put the perfect device inside Betsy's leg now. A lot of people think that a bionic limb is any limb that just fits on a human or an animal. That's not true. The vast majority of so-called bionic limbs are just a socket that fits on the stump and does not directly link onto the skeleton. Perfits are a permanent part of the body, but of course their success depend on mechanical and biological factors. And if infection gets in, that's a massive problem. Table up, please.
To give Betsy her bionic foot, Noel begins by removing the lower part of her remaining limb.
We've taken the carpal bones away now. The wrist is gone.
Then he uses 3D printed cutting guides to shape the radius and ulna bones ready for the implant.
We leave as much of the skin as we can at this stage.
Betsy's endoprosthesis consists of 5 elements. A peg is inserted into the radius. The radius and ulna bones sit on a platform. 2 plates are secured to the bones with overlapping locking screws. Bone graft from the amputated bone is packed between the radius and ulna. Then the muscle is stitched onto one half of a mesh dome and the skin onto the other. Finally, an external prosthesis is attached to the spigot of the implant using a clamp. After drilling a hole inside the radius, Noel pops the implant into position.
Should fit like a glove because we've measured it like so. Okay, so now we screw the plates onto the bone.
After packing in the bone graft, Noel can stitch up.
So the skin will gradually shrink onto the dome in coming days, and hopefully it will form a permanent seal around the end of the metal so that the infection can't get in. And if infection gets in, that's a massive problem. Give me the foot, please.
Finally, the exoprosthesis, which is Betsy's new foot, is screwed into place.
An hour can be the difference between having a leg and not having a leg. Right, Betsy, there you go. You got a new bionic paw, sweetheart.
With the mechanics in place, it's now down to biology. Only if the skin seals and Betsy avoids infection will the surgery be a success. In the wards, 9-month-old Angel is recovering from the operation to treat her bowed front limbs.
I can't believe we're going to see her.
Now 3 days since the surgery, Kirsty and daughter Freya have arrived to take the puppy home.
It's been horrible, hasn't it? It's been emotional. We've got 3 days worth of cuddles and snuggles to give her, so she's going to get loads of attention. She's your doggie, isn't she? So you picked her, yeah. And she's little like us too. Hiya.
Hello. I don't think we've met before, have we?
No.
What's your name?
Freya.
And who's that friend you've got there? What's this one's name?
Mini Angel.
Mini Angel. Oh, I see. So that's Mini Angel, and I've been looking after Maxi Angel, have I?
Yeah.
All right. Well, Maxi Angel is doing very well.
Oh, brilliant.
So, Mummy, what I've done is I've taken a bit out of the ulna,
yep,
and I've put a bridge across here.
Yeah.
And what this bridge does is it stops that bit growing.
Yeah.
This bit may grow more and push the foot back in.
Perfect, yeah.
I may have to take that out.
Yeah.
In a few weeks' time, depending on how things go. Yep. Are we ready for little Angel to see big Angel?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Now, who have we got here, Angel? Now, there we go. There we go. Look at that.
Oh, baby.
Look at that. Now, doesn't she look well?
Yeah,
well
perfect.
Done, Angel.
Thanks ever so much.
No problem.
Oh, amazing. I've missed her so much. So, I can't even explain how happy I am to have her back. Yeah, as you can see, she's quite an energetic, so it's going to be, I think, quite difficult, but, I mean, it's got to be done, so we'll find a way. Hey, we'll find a way. Aww.
What are you cooking? Yes. Yes, you're very good. Oh, she's so good. Look at her. Good.
Since her bionic limb surgery last week...
Kisses everywhere. Kisses everywhere.
I love them.
Eager to please puppy Betsy has been having daily bandage changes...
Good girl.
...to check if the skin is sealing...
So far, so good. Good girl, Betsy.
...and to make sure there's no sign of infection.
Scratch my head, because with the pastel collar you cannot. Can you? Yeah.
Hi, mate. Hi.
Hello.
Hi, buddy. Betsy's doing pretty good. She's now 5 days post-op and she is standing on the leg. That's not good. All right. Right, I need to ring Mom. I'm going to need to open it up. Can you get Lisa to get the Allen keys so I can take the foot off, please? This dog's now going to have to go to ISO.
Oh, Betsy Boop.
Hello?
Oh, hi, Dan. It's Noel here. So, as you know, we're changing the dressing daily on Betsy. But unfortunately, there is discharge from the wound tonight of probably the same bacteria that was in the foot originally. And that leaves us with only two options, trying to treat the infection or taking the leg off entirely.
What's the option then, in terms of trying to treat it?
The option is open up all the skin around the dome, flush it, and then try and resuture at a later date. But of course, there's the ethical issues of putting her through all of that. And we either go down that route for a few days and see, or we go for full limb amputation in the next 24, 48 hours.
Yeah, and there's no guarantee that if you manage to clear this infection, she wouldn't get another one, right?
That's right. She's in good spirits. It's not affecting her in terms of her demeanor, but clearly we could fail no matter what we do now.
One of the reasons why limb amputation prosthesis surgery is not more widely adopted is failure. When you've put more than a decade of effort into the evolution of the prosthesis and the engineering and surgery have all gone to plan, but yet biology doesn't smile, it's utterly devastating.
Can I have the key, please?
Most people do opt for full limb amputation, which is entirely reasonable. But at every stage, you discuss the ethics with the family. And if they choose to fight on, then decisive and definitive action is required because you're fighting a war. You've got 1 week to win that war or that limb is lost.
Any further treatment must be ethically in Betsy's best interest, but action cannot be delayed.
Tonight I'm going to treat the infection and overnight Sophie and Dan are going to decide if they want me to take the limb off completely.
The area is flushed with saline.
Be conscious that everything you touch has bugs on it.
Then Noel makes an attack on the bacteria causing the infection.
We will only do this for a very limited time period because otherwise it's not in Betsy's best interest. We're seeking to decolonize the area. Then we're going to give antibiotics. And we're going to pray.
It's been 6 weeks now since Angel the puppy with little limbs had surgery on her bowed front legs.
Angel.
She's been on cage rest at home.
It's definitely like having a baby, full-time work. But to be fair, she hasn't like cried once, she hasn't whimpered, she's been excellent, yeah. Angel.
Noel wants to check if he needs to remove the screw and wire bridges he put into Angel's legs.
Angel!
If the scan shows the bones are twisting in the other direction...
Hello?
Angel could face further surgery.
Look into this angel eyes.
Hi, guys. Come on in. What you will notice is that that growth plate is now closed. Okay. There's going to be no more growth there.
Yeah.
Which is good. Also, what you'll notice is that the wrist straightened up a bit because the growth continued a bit on the outside for a few more weeks. And the ulna is filling in with fibrous tissue, which is becoming bone. So I'm happy to say that we do not need to take the implants out and that, in fact, her legs are perfectly functional and happy.
In terms of, exercise...
In terms of exercise now, my strong advice to you is get her fit and don't let her get fat.
Yeah.
Because she'll have a big body and short legs. And there's nothing you can do about that. But at least you've saved her from significant joint incongruity, significant osteoarthritis, and that is a massive thing you've done for her.
Cheers. Oh my God, I am absolutely over the moon. We've got to make sure that she stays fit and healthy because we don't want to put any pressure on her bones, really. And he doesn't have to do any more operations at all. So that was the best result that we could have got today. Come on,
Well done, Betsy, good girl.
In the isolation ward...
You're such a good girl, well done.
It's been a tense few weeks.
Betsy's been in isolation now for the last couple of weeks because of the infection in her leg. Now, the skin looks good.
The plucky pup has overcome infection again. And she's got the all clear to go home.
We've been really looking forward to bringing her home. We weren't sure if we'd get to bring her home this soon. So, very excited.
Hugo's very excited.
He looks really excited.
How are you today and how's Hugo?
He's doing well today.
He was having a bit of a wah, but
I heard
okay.
I heard it. So far, you've been incredibly unlucky and incredibly lucky.
Yeah.
You've been incredibly unlucky that the infection from the gangrene foot came back. Mm. You've been incredibly lucky that so far the revision surgery has worked. Most people opt for amputation at that point.
One of your interns can write a nice case report.
Yes, yes. Well, everything in science is going to be based on evidence. Any questions before the missile comes through the door, the missile of love?
To what extent do we need to keep her limb kind of protected?
You don't need to protect her limb. You need to protect yourself from her knocking you out with her limb.
Right.
Because this is like a pogo stick of pudge.
Yeah.
I'll get her. Now, missus. Come on. There we go.
Look at you!
Hi!
Look at you! Bionic doggo!
Oh, I can see you could do some damage with that.
Yeah, she would definitely bash you with that foot.
Yeah.
Yes, well done. Shall we walk outside a little bit and just show you the walk? Come on then.
At last, Betsy has her bionic foot. But she's still got some practicing to do.
Yeah, that's it, perfect. Just a 1 foot rub, a little shorter, please. That's it. And she'll get the hang of it over time. She just, when she calms down, she uses it much better.
Yeah.
All right, well done, missus. Well done, we love you. And we shall miss you.
7 months since the accident.
Thanks, Dolph.
Okay, God bless.
It's a moment the family thought they'd never see.
It's been such a long journey, but it's a huge relief.
Just amazing. So happy. It was the right decision to have one last try at saving it.
You're a silly conehead.
Good girl.
In the Midlands, bite-sized dog de Bordeaux puppy Angel.
I sit and wait. Yeah. There's an angel.
Has been perfecting her doggy paddle.
As part of Angel's recovery, Noel recommended that we took her to some hydrotherapy sessions just to help aid with her recovery and to build her strength back up.
Yeah. It's 10 weeks since she had the surgery on both her front legs.
She's coped really well. We've had to keep her on strict bed rest. I think it's been harder because she's a puppy, but obviously we've had to make sure that we're quite strict with her.
Angel!
Now she's allowed out with one of her brothers.
I'm loving angels instead.
Oh, it's brilliant. It's so nice to see her out and about and playing. That's all we could have ever hoped for, really. And as you can see, she's loving it. No pain at all. So, yeah, it's absolutely fantastic.
It makes me feel happy that Angel actually gets to run around with her brother for the first time in ages.
So she's got a new lease of life, wants to get out for a walk, so she's absolutely loving life.
Yeah, she's loving life.
Come on, you can do it. Absolutely over the moon, yeah.
Good girl, Betsy. Show us your foot, come on.
Yeah.
It's been nearly a year since the accident that left puppy Betsy in a critical condition and unable to use her right front paw.
Good girl. Betsy's doing really well. She's taken to this new foot and she's just so happy. She's amazingly quick on it, especially when running after the cat in the house.
She's
running so well?
Just like a normal dog. Wait until she finds out how to use it to dig.
It did at times feel like everything was against Betsy.
And she's off again. The second infection was really a blow. I mean, I thought after everything that we'd done, we were gonna have to amputate her leg. And it was, yeah, it was really hard. Good girl. So then when Noel managed to save it, it was amazing.
I feel like Betsy is the reason why we are here, you know? Because it would have been so easy to have given up on Betsy from day one.
Snow? We've never seen snow before.
And I think Betsy just represents what teamwork and family can achieve when we actually believe that the outcome can be successful.
I think we're very glad that we persisted through all the complications she had.
You know, we had to take some risks along the way, but we're very lucky in that it's all paid off. We're here today with Betsy on her all four paws.
Good girl.
And if you can't get enough of Professor Noel, and let's face it, who can't? The whole series of The Supervet is available to watch right now on All Four. Next, though, here on Channel 4, halfway through, and it's a word that fills some of us with horror. Exercise. How will they cope in 21 days? Body turnaround with Michael Molesey.